Good morning, children. Welcome to Early Foundation International School. So, before going to start our today's class, what we have to see? Yes, it's today's retail day. Coming for today's date, it is 24. We are in the month what? September. So, 09, and the year is 2021, and the day is Friday. So, before going to watch your video, you are ready with one of these things. Yes, you are ready with your textbook. You are ready with your workbook. Then you are ready with pencil. Okay, children, then start watching the video. Yes, children. So you will be having today your EBS2, that is your social science. In that, we are going to continue the same topic. What is it? Lesson A, using and making maps. Yes. So just we will recall the last class what we have learned regarding this. Okay. Yes, what we have learned? We have learned about the different maps. Yes, what are the different maps we have learned? We have learned about a house map, then route map, then the what? Country map, isn't it? So in detail we have learned about this. Yes, so students? Yes. Today we are going to read about the using maps. So how we are going to using the maps? Yes, we look at a place. We look at a place from above to make map, isn't it? So map shows the top view of the place, and map also helps to locate our position. What are the two things? So here they have the map mentioned two things. What is the first thing? So it shows the top view of a place. Next thing. Location, that is a location of a position, isn't it? So the map shows two things. But how to use a map? Yes, we point out landmarks on map. So we point what over? So what we point out? We point landmarks. We point landmarks on map. So now you will get a doubt, isn't it? What is a landmark? Yes, I'll tell you. Landmark is a building or object that is easy to locate from a distance. What is a landmark? So the landmark is a distance. Sorry, landmark is a building. Landmark is a building or object located. Object that is easy to locate from a distance. That is easy to locate from a distance. Okay, this is about the landmark. So, for using map, what are the things we can learn? We can learn top view of that place. Next is the location of a position of that place. Okay, so on the map, how we are going to identify the map? So, what by the landmark? What is a landmark? Landmark is a building or object that is easy to locate from a distance. Okay. take the east direction, that is they have to turn right to the bookshop. There tower in the left side of the bookshop, they have to turn on the right side. On the road they have to cross on the right side to go to the park. See, you have to mention like this. Or here they have given the place here, no? You have to write on that Rashi and Mehar as you take what? East position. They have to turn on the east and they have to go for a park. Okay, you have to write down in this textbook and you have to sign that fit for me. Yes, some map shows a large area. This means that only few important things are marked on them. Means some maps will show a large area, that is big area. Example, the map of India. Yes, in the last class we learned regarding this, isn't it? So in India we have learned that how the water, where the water bodies is there, where the landmark is there, and where the hills were there, where the mountains were there, isn't it? Yes, you just recall it. We can't see our house or school on a on a map of India, isn't it? Can we see? No, it is a country map. Country map is so big, but in route map we can see our house, isn't it? So now you got a difference, right, children? Yes. Next, some map shows us every small thing in a place. Example, a map of your neighborhood should show every building and shop. Yes, it is a which map? It is a house map. Sorry, it is a root map. In the root map, you can see our neighbor's house, shops, everything, isn't it? So this map needs correct measurements. We need to measure the space between two places or objects. Measurements helps to mark the correct position of things on map. So if you have to write down your neighbors, that is neighbor map, just to imagine, children, see, there is a home. Okay, just to consider, this is a home, and here is then a shop. Okay, here you may have a shop like this. Okay, shop, and in between there is a road, and here you just consider it is a park. Okay, so after that you may have some few buildings, that is few buildings. So you have to go for a shop. Your neighbor house. This is the houses. See, you are going to mark this map using a dotted lines, isn't it? So this is the neighbor. Map here, what you can observe? You can observe the houses, park, shops, and everything. But how you can do it? With the proper measurement. What it should include? Proper measurement. Next, particular place. Okay, particular place should be there, and particular place should be there, and proper measurement should be there before going to mark the map. Yes, measurement help to mark the correct position of things on map. What the measurement will do? The measurement is going to help to mark the correct position. Correct positions of things on map. So this is the, what is the function of measurement? The measurement helps to mark the correct position of things on map, on a route map. This is about neighbor map is a route map. Okay. So please open your question, page number 16. See, here they have given one map. See, they have given a large map with the measurement. See, straight lines drawn on a map divide it into many equal parts. We can use these parts to find a place or objects quickly. The map gives by the measurement they have been cutted. So here you can in a one, A1 it is a house, isn't it? Next, here B it may be a school or a hospital, and C it is a what? C it is a building, isn't it? Here you can see the shop, and this there they have given a path, then the direction. See, from this study each part of the map carefully and answer the question. Based on this they have given the questions. On your notebook you have to write down this questions and you should send in a group. Okay. First question: in which part is the building with the blue windows located? So blue windows located where? Where the blue windows located? Yes, here blue windows is there. No, it is C1. Yes, no. Measurement C1. You can name it. Next, what color is the building in A1? So A1 what color? So it is like a pale yellow color. You have to write down. Next, where is the sign with the direction placed on the map? Yes, it is in the 3, position 3. It is a what? Sign with the direction placed on a map. Okay, this is the activity you have to do. You have to observe this carefully, and for this also you should write down what it is, and for this also it is you have to write down this. Okay, so today we learned how to use the map, and we have known today also we know the differences of what is house map, what is route map, and how why we should not use the country map. So for us, which is the best map? It is a route map, isn't it? Yes, this is about your today's class, but you will be having homework. Children, please open your workbook. In that, please open page number 14. Still question number 11 we have finished in the last class, isn't it? So coming for question number 12, short answer question: why are landmarks useful? Give two reasons. You have to tell us, because it is going to what? Locate the building, or so it is going to locate the building from a far distance. You have to write down. Next, how is the map of India different from the map of our neighborhood? State a reason why correct measurements are important while making map. Yes, because the area is so large, we can't find the neighborhood in the country map. But when we are having a neighborhood map, it is easy to find out our place, and easily we can reach the place within a time. If the measurements is there, easily we can draw the map. Okay, you have to write down. Next, long answer question: the following map has been divided into parts. Use these parts of the map to answer the following question. See, they have been given this. Like this, see, they have given 1, 2, they have marked 1, 2, 3, and they have cut the positions A, B, C. Okay, they have given everything. So A, what is shown in A3? What it has been shown, see, in A3, it shows the keys. You have to write down. Next, where are the entrance gates? Where is the entrance gate? Yes, it is in the B1, in the B1, the entrance gate. Where does this picture appear on the map? What does it show? So on C1 it is there. On the C1 it has been appeared. So this is a what? Direction. It is a direction. You have to write down. Okay. So your today's homework is from question number 12 to question number 14. Yes, you hope you will do it right. Yes. Yes, children. You will do it right. Yes, we will meet you in the next class with the new concept of the same topic continue. But please do your homework and send it quick within 8 p.m. So we will meet you in the next class. Until then, take care.